Hello students,
today we start our chapter number 1. The name is relation and function. Basic of relation and function we already done in 11th standard. So first of all, recall that the definition of relation from two functions or two sets. If A and B are two non-empty sets, then any subset of A cross B, we know that the relation is denoted by A cross B, is called a relation from A to B. Okay, for example, if we take A is equal to 1, B is equal to 0.2 and 3.4. So A cross B, we can write like this: 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3, 2, 4, so on. This, and we already learned in 11th standard there is domain, codomain, range of functions. If the number of elements in A is n and the number of relation of A is equal to 2 times to n square. So here this point is for MCQ. If the given answer is A is equal to 1, 2, then how many relations you make it of A? So we have put how many members? 2. So 2 square 4, 2 raised to 4, 16. So the answer is like this. Okay. So this meant for only MCQ. Next definition, empty relation of A. You know that empty means no, nothing in set. Subset 5 of A cross A is called empty relation on A. If we take A is equal to 1, 2. Now relation is given. If here A and B, we take A plus C is greater than or 5. So the answer is always wrong, because 1 plus 2, 3, B is not greater than 5. So our answer is 5 or empty relation. Universal relation on A. Subset A cross A of A cross A is called the universal relation. If we take one set, 1, 2, then the answer is always sum or all set are in other set. So it is known as universal relation. Now, next types of relation. Reflexive. First, there is 4 types. First, reflexive relation. Relation R is said to be reflexive in and if and only if. For all A belongs to A, A belongs to, suppose the A is equal to 1, 2. Now the relation R1, that is the one point, is 1, 1 and 1, 2, 2. If the answer is like this relation, so here see, in this state we have to take two numbers are sent, 1, 1, 2, 2. If 1, 2 are there, then it is not possible. So it is not a reflex. In simple language, A is equal to A. Both numbers are same. Then it is known as reflexive. Now, symmetric. Relation R is said to be symmetric. If and only if, or A belongs to R, B belongs to R. In this case, the number will be interchange its position. If here R2, taking R2, 1, 2, 1. If the relation are displayed like this, so it is known as symmetric relation. It is called reflexive. It is called symmetric. Now last, transitive relation. Relation R is said to be transitive if and only if for all AB belongs to R, BC belongs to R and AC belongs to R. Okay. In here our simple language is described like this: A is equal to A is equal to B, E is equal to B. For this case, A is equal to B, E is equal to B. All are equal. If we take 1, 2 and 3, 1, 2, 3, then R 3, 1, 2, 2, 1 and 1, 3. If the answer is like this, so we can get it. You can see here A, B, B, C. A, B, B, C and A, C. So here A, 1, C, example. Now that's equivalence relation. If the, for equivalence, the relative are, relation R on a set A is to be an equivalence relation, if and only if R is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. It means if the first, second and third, all conditions will be satisfied, 1, 2 and 3, all conditions will be satisfied, then the relation is known as equivalence relation. Exercise 1.1, question number 1, determine whether each of the following relations are reflexive, symmetric and transitive. We have to prove that. Okay, so first, relation R in the set A is equal to 1 to 3 up to 15. So 1 to 15 defined as R xy dx minus y is equal to 0. So here the condition are given, that is dx minus y is equal to 0. If the side change of y, so we get y is equal to 3x. Now you have what to do, just put value of here from this set, x is equal to 1, then you get 3 1s are 3, x is equal to 2, 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9, 3 4s are 12. If I put x is equal to 5, so I get 15. Okay, so all you have to do it, go further or else that's it. Okay. Now R 1, 3, 2, 6, 3, 9, and 4, 12. Okay, so here first for x, second for y, x is equal to 1, 3, 2, 6, 3, 9, 4, 12. Now check here, 1 belongs to A, but 1, 1 is not here. Either 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, not available, so not belongs to us. So R is not reflexive. We know that if reflexive A is equal to A, for symmetric A is equal to B, B is equal to A. And last, A is equal to B, B is equal to C, and A is equal to C. Second one, 1, 3 is here, but 3, 1 is not here. So, not belongs to R is not symmetric. Last, 1, 3, 3, 9, but 1, 9 is not available. So, that is also R is not transitive. Next one, relation R is the set of natural number, of the natural number as defined as y is equal to x plus 5. And x is less than 4. Now, less than 4 and the given set is natural number. So, start with 1, 2 and 3. That's it, because less than 4. So, if we put here 1, so 1 plus 5, y is equal to 6. If we put 2, then y is equal to 7, 3, then 8. So, our relation becomes 1, 6. Here, x and y are equal. So, x is equal to 1, then y is equal to 6. 2, 7, 3, 8. 1 belongs to N, but 1, 1 is not belongs to R. So, it is not reflexive. 1, 6 available, but 6, 1 is not here. So, it is not symmetric. Similarly, 1, 6 belongs to R, but 6 is not assigned with any number, with any number of element. So, R is not transitive. Third is, relation R in the set A is equal to 1 to 6 S. Y is divisible by x. So y is divisible by x, then x, y belongs to. Okay. Here, condition is y is divisible. So 1 is divided by 1. 2 is divided by, yes, 1. 3 divided by 1. 4. 5 divided by 1. 6 divided by 1. Now, 1 is, next one is 2, 1. So 1 is not divided by 2. 2 divided by 2. 3 divided by 2, not possible. So 4 divided by 2. 5 divided by 2 not possible, 6 by 2, 3 by 3, 6 by 3, 4 upon 4 possible, 5 by 5 and 6 by 6. This type of relation we get, R is equal to this set we get. Now for all, x belongs to x divides x, so R is reflexive. It means here you can write like this, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6 belongs to R. So it is reflexive. Second one, 1, belong, 1, 2 belongs to R, but 2, 1 is not belongs to R. Okay? So it is not symmetric. Now here we take one example and prove it. Otherwise, we want to prove like this, 1, 1 belongs to R, then 1 belongs to 6, or 1, 5 belongs to 1, 1 belongs to R, 1, 5 belongs to R, and 5 belongs to 5. We can prove like this. Similarly for 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2 So first condition is this. Let for x belongs to a, y belongs to z, z belongs to a. X, y belongs to a, and y z belongs to a. That is already given. Y is divisible by x, and z is divisible by x. Now y is equal to mx, and z is equal to y. N, y. Now z is equal to n. Y is equal to r, and x. So put here mx. So m, n, x. But we take mn is equal to p. It means z is divisible by x. So R is transitive. Fourth one, relation R in the set Z of all integers defined as R is equal to x, y. X minus y is an integer. Here, x belongs to Z, y belongs to Z, and x minus y is an integer already given. But for x belongs to Z and y belongs to Z, so we know that both integers number are subtracted, so we get integer. So for all x belongs to z, y belongs to z, x, y belongs to r. So r is equal to z cross z. It means the both set are integer set. So that's why if we subtract the number, then we get also integer. So r is an universal relation. If it is universal relation, then r is reflection, symmetric, and transitive.